In 2021, NFTs, also known as non-fungible tokens, grew to become a $41 billion industry, quickly catching up to the $50 billion conventional art industry. Beyond digital art, however, many are wondering what the innovation of NFTs truly means for our everyday lives and where they're headed. This is Evan Shapiro.
Hey, I'm Evan Shapiro. I am the CEO of the Mina Foundation and a co-founder of Mina Protocol.
He's been thinking deeper about the impact of NFTs and how Mina Protocol, with the power of zero knowledge, could push the boundaries of current use cases. So, Evan, explain to us, what's an NFT?
Maybe it would help to just kind of start off by giving just a technical definition. You have these tokens that are interchangeable. So, you know, I can own a token, you can own a token, they're fungible, they're interchangeable. In an NFT world, each token corresponds exactly to one piece of information directly, and whoever owns that NFT can also be said to like have some association to that associated data. One way I think about NFTs is you have these communities and you have these assets that are part of these communities, and those communities place real value on those assets. In some sense, you're just owning like a piece of data on a blockchain to that community. That is a real thing that you are owning.
Owning. Up until now, the industry has grasped onto owning NFTs as these ephemeral markers of wealth or assets. Are there any other ways they could be useful, though?
So one place I think NFTs can be very useful is when someone is starting a new project, a new community, there is a real need for capital and a real challenge oftentimes to being able to obtain that capital to be able to actually launch their project. I think NFTs do offer an opportunity for a new community that is spinning up around an idea, but they're just getting started. They need capital to like build their operations, to kind of take on a opportunity to like allocate out assets that will be scarce in that future community. I think there will always be some communities that will have NFTs as a part of them. The question is, will those be a few dozen communities on crypto Twitter, or will that be every major artist that is in existence? The advantage you get with a blockchain is like the kind of more kind of pure ownership model over the Kickstarter. At the end of the day, if I, you know, do this through a Kickstarter, you have just this tangled web of what ownership means in that non-programmatic world, whereas in a cryptocurrency world, like, not only is this proof of my ownership cryptographic, but also you can trade it easily in the ways that we're used to on cryptocurrencies now.
It's interesting thinking about NFT ownership as a way to build communities. I wonder, though, are there any potential problems, and do you see a way for zero knowledge to help out here?
There are definitely some drawbacks, especially relating to privacy, that something like zero knowledge is super essential to solving. Oftentimes, these NFTs are signifiers of your position within a community, but to do that, to own an NFT right now, you end up doxing the rest of all of your Ethereum information outside of the confines of just that community. I have my identity within one community. Maybe I don't want everyone to see all my activity on DeFi, how long I've been in crypto, like all these other things that are unrelated to the specific NFT world that I'm trying to inhabit with my NFTs. So I think if we want to decouple that and allow people to have identities that are separate in these different communities, and if, like, it's super important to have some form of privacy with zero knowledge to make it happen. I think that, like, outside privacy, one particular way that ZKPs can be really useful in thinking about NFTs is about providing these proofs of kind of like the authentic chain of creation of an NFT. If I want to take a tweet that I made and I want to, in a fully decentralized way, turn it into an NFT, ZK Oracle's allowing proofs to make that possible to happen. Whereas instead you might want to have some centralized service do it otherwise. At the very least, being able to say, maybe this particular Twitter handle has verified that they are the originator of this NFT, so that in this future NFT world, at the very least, there's not this degree of fraudulism around the authenticity of the creation of NFTs. I guess to mention like one more class of things I think that could be cool about NFTs that don't exist right now, and that could eventually end up being somewhat positive, is the opportunity for ZKPs to allow extra proofs around NFT ownership. For example, saying each person can only own at most one NFT from a set of NFTs. with that, you can have people like kind of like gobbling up the entire set, for example. I think Mina can be particularly interesting for developers that want to start experimenting with this stuff and otherwise wouldn't have access to zero knowledge, because it's been so hard to program with zero knowledge historically. The ability to start using some of this stuff from within TypeScript suddenly means that if I am a developer that wants to experiment with NFTs or some of like the possible futures here, hopefully the pro-social ones, I can start doing that through Mina.
Nice. Seems like there's many unique use cases for NFTs that haven't been fully tapped into yet. And Mina is enabling easy programmability of zero-knowledge smart contracts, or what we call ZK apps, using TypeScript. This means many developers will be able to build NFTs with privacy features while connecting to any website via ZK oracles. You can learn about other use cases for zero-knowledge proofs in these videos. Give this video a like if you found it interesting, and if you want to learn more about Mina or how zero-knowledge will continue to make an impact in the NFT space, subscribe to this channel and follow us on Twitter. Thanks for watching.